Good evening, good afternoon. This is Jody with Whispers. Whispers ASMR. And tonight we are going to be talking about the ghosts of Ohio. The ghosts of Ohio in a whisper. This content will be whispered, so if you do not like whispers, very intriguing subject for me. I really, really find it to be fascinating. So we're going to go to different counties. We're going to start in Ashtabula County. It is the most so these are haunting and legends, but many, oddly enough, I have experienced myself, so I know they're not just legends, and they're not just hauntings, they are real. This is absolutely true, true, true. I have felt it, I have seen it for my own eyes, and for many years I thought I was crazy because known as the Pymatuning Reservoir Swamp, actually swamp before it was dammed and filled. This reservoir is home to a ghostly galley ship. A ship, that's right, that got stuck in Lake Erie on a cold, stormy night. Because Lake Erie can actually become very, very, very dangerous within minutes. If you don't realize this about Lake Erie, then you can get into situations like this man who lost his ship due to a storm that all of a sudden appeared. And that is what happens in 1760 and 1830, in between those years. Lost on Lake Erie when it was a swamp. I can't imagine Lake Erie being a swamp, but it was. The footage of the ship was 60 feet long. That is a large vessel. See, her crew vanished. Lake Erie is cold winter. nights and have seen strange orb-like lights that are hovering out in the fog. The spillway could be associated with this. A girl has been seen in the water. Hair up, golden blonde, float. Have been taken of her. Photos have been taken of her floating in the waters right by where the ship disappeared. The haunting is thought to be associated Center. The woman, an old woman, has been reportedly seen walking the halls. A ghostly figure of a woman who died many years ago in the train disaster. There, in Chestnut disaster all on his own because he designed the bridge and was the architect. He felt he should have known that he needed more stability. He needed more stabilization. He needed more strength to hold a train that size, or any train, really. So he committed suicide. Colin's ghost is often seen leaning against the memorial created from the townspeople for the disaster. This playground is now a park, but it is haunted by children who died in a school fire in the late 1800s. Now, the school burnt to the ground. However, the children are still in the park where the school. Witnesses describe that you can hear the whispers of these children, and namely David is called out very clearly. He was known to be an athlete because when the children are playing a also a little girl that walks on the edge of the playground or of the park now, but she is thought to be an outcast, for she has never been seen talking to anybody or looking at anybody, but she appears the most out of any of the other ghosts that live in this area. She is sad and forlorn for something. Even in death, sometimes we cannot forget the loss of our loved ones. Geneva. The step above bar you will find closes at 9 o'clock, but the patrons there will stay long after, just drinking. Eat. must be something that happened there because of the amount of children all congregating in that place, like during a dance or something. Somebody or something had happened where they all were perished. Of the burial spot of Levi and Ruth. is why they traveled to Ohio, to get away from that stigma. But Levi started a church, a small church in Kirtland that later evolved into Mormonism. Steve doing. if she was angry at her husband or something, because for a ghost, they usually rearrange furniture or things of that nature, but that is very specific. Fishermen that hanged a young couple from the bridge when they walked to on them. Felt slave is said to haunt the building and its underground tunnels. And I just want to say that I was, in my research, I was reading, and I did not know this, and I doubt they teach this in history class because it is so terrible. But some of the people from up north that would direct or quote-unquote be helpful in the Underground Railroad would actually be there to capture certain slaves and sell them again for a profit if nobody else was watching.
little bit.